Whiskey collecting doesn't have to be what you think it is. It's not really rocket science. Tricky? Yes, absolutely. Rocket science? No. And despite what you think or may have heard, it doesn't have to be an expensive pastime or hobby either. That's a common misconception. It can be, and more than likely will be, expensive if you allow it. Perhaps you're in it for a nest egg, maybe for significance, maybe because you love the look of a bottle or the history and practices of a specific distillery. Whatever your reasons, the Chaser has got you covered. Let's get stuck in. Welcome to Whiskey and Whiskey. I'm the Whiskey Chaser Brian, coming to you from Christie's Bar in the home of Irish Whiskey, Kilkenny, Ireland. Firstly, this video is for complete beginners when it comes to collecting whiskey. All right, and actually maybe a few seasoned vets might pick up a thing or two, but really it's for complete noobs who are looking to get into a bit of whiskey collecting. And to be honest, this video isn't really about specific types or regions or brands of whiskey to collect. It's really a one-size-fits-all guide to help you on your way into the wonderful and sometimes scary world of whiskey collecting. So let's get started. I myself have been known to collect a few rare Irish whiskies, and I started out the hard way, and I've made a few expensive mistakes along the way. So I want to help you not to do that, because regardless of the whiskey collecting mistake you make, you kind of tend not to forget about it. And being completely honest with you, it really does become a thorn in your ass. The mistake, not the whiskey. So let's get a few very important things out of the way that people tend to overlook when it comes to whiskey collecting. And this is a free bonus point, just because I'm a hell of a nice guy. Whatever your reasons for getting into collecting, make sure it's for you and for your enjoyment. Don't be influenced, or try not to be influenced, by other people's collecting habits. For example, if you want to collect certain bottlings from the year you or your kids were born, do that. If you want to try and collect all of one specific style that you like, well then absolutely, go for it. If you want to collect just one distillery's releases, perfect. Do just that. Make sure it's for you, and that it's for fun. There are loads of different types of collectors. Pick your reason, pick your region, start small, and remember, you don't always have to stick with it if you don't like it. You can always drink it. Now, something very similar can be said for why you collect. Maybe you want to collect for that one day when you retire. You have a nice little nest egg there for yourself. Or you might just want to collect all of the miniatures, the little 5 mil or 50 mil ones. Or maybe you want to drink them all with friends someday. Or perhaps you want to wait for a loved one to become of age or return home or a meet up with friends. And that's why you're collecting. My point here is, like, don't let anyone tell you what's right or wrong. Oh yeah, and don't listen to anyone that says whiskey is for drinking. Shut up. Whiskey's for doing whatever the damn hell you want to do with it once you paid for it. It's yours. Do you. With all of that out of the way, let's get into 10 whiskey collecting tips for complete noobs. Jazz hands. If you're going down the road of collecting, I cannot stress this enough. It is quite possibly the most important factor on this list. Honest to God. One word rhymes with me search, and that's research. Do your research, do your research, do your research, do your research, do your research. I cannot say this enough times. There are literally thousands of releases, bottle numbers, limited editions, special editions, limited bottlings, distillery releases, bottle sizes, travel exclusives. The list does truly go on. Research the brand, research the release, research past auctions. Find out literally as much as you possibly can about the bottle of whiskey you want to acquire. Use the internet, everything is there, I do promise you this. And for the love of God, don't blind buy. This is where we tend to get burnt and overpay on some bottles that aren't worth that much at all. Trust me, brand and bottle research can really help you out. If you have two bottles where they look identical and one bottle is worth hundreds more than another, well, the chances are there's something unique and special to that one bottling that costs substantially more. It could be a first release. It might have been distilled in a different distillery or under a different master distiller. Some batches switch over sometimes. Without proper research, we're buying blind. That, my friends, is a big no-no. Numero dos, budget or don't. But know that if you don't budget, things get out of hand very, very quickly. If you budget, then prepare to miss out on some releases from time to time. Unfortunately, you can't really have it both ways. Set a budget at the start, see how it's going, and then after a while, reassess. I didn't budget, and looking back now, and with the gift of hindsight, I kind of wish I had. But look, water under the bridge. Oh, I will throw an extra point in here under number two here. Try concentrate your focus on one specific type of whiskey or distillery starting out. If your focus is a distillery, chances are they won't release 20 different releases all at once in different parts of the world, which helps with the budgeting. Unless, of course, it's Bushmills or Waterford. Then your budget is completely screwed anyway. Number three, it's the magic number. Whiskey sets. I love a good whiskey set. I do. I really do. I tried chasing a few of them. They're not easy. Whiskey sets are amazingly fun to collect, but don't expect a huge payday if you plan to sell them all at once down the road. Whiskey collectors around the world are just like you, searching for a bargain, and they won't pay over the odds. You shouldn't either, but if you're looking to collect a set, just be careful. Long term, keep in mind that with sets, bottle numbers can run incredibly high and might not be released in just your country. There could be worldwide releases, and that becomes a logistical nightmare. Also, it is kind of incredibly rewarding when you get them home after finding a rare one in the wild somewhere. But remember, whiskey bottles are made of glass. Glass don't travel too well. And if you can at all, start the collection early on, like at the very start, where the bottles are at cost price. That saves a lot of heartache. Four. Limited editions. My God, did I fall for this one. Limited edition is such a loose term. Is it limited to a certain market? Is it limited to just your country or just to a liquor store or off license that you buy from? How many bottles are in this limited release? Is it limited release part one? Until the marketing department realizes they've hit a home run and then they decide to do a full core range release again. Research here plays a big part. Just don't fall for the hype, man. Pretty sure this is number five, low bottle number releases. Generally speaking, anything below a 500-ish bottle release is a very limited edition, in fact, right? If it's a worldwide release, then even more so. If there's a release of 10,000 bottles and it's for a smaller area, that's a huge release and possibly not worth your time for monetary purposes. If it's 10,000 bottle release worldwide, then that might be a different story. Email the distillery, ask what markets the bottles are available in, what size releases it is, etc., etc. You might get a response, or you might have to dig a little bit deeper. There are tons of Facebook groups out there with very knowledgeable people that might know the answers. You don't know from what distillery people are lurking in the crowd. So just make sure you ask the questions. If you're collecting to someday drink the whiskey, then it's not really relevant. It doesn't really matter to you. It does kind of boil down to the popularity and following up the distillery has, how well the product is too. So again, research is key, especially if you plan to drink it. No point in spending all that money on a bottle number 10 if when you open it, the whiskey tastes like shit. Number six, I think, age is a driving factor. Knowing this is important too. Generally speaking, the older the whiskey, the more value it has. Some non-age statement whiskeys are hitting the market lately that have eye-watering price tags. To me, that's hardly justifiable, unless you're invested in that distillery with other bottlings. You're kind of caught then. If you're collecting to drink, a non-age statement whiskey with a high price tag certainly should be approached with an element of caution first. See, can you try a sample from bottle shares or online sample catalogs? They are out there, just type it into the old Google there. Not all age statement whiskeys and non-age statement whiskeys, for that matter, released by distillery are their own whiskey. Just bear that in mind, keep that to the forefront, especially, you know, here in Ireland. A lot of new distilleries and indeed new merchants have come online and sourced whiskeys from other distilleries and then bottled and released that whiskey under their own brand name. It's a thing. Research this beforehand. There's that word again. Numero seven, if you can, get in at the release slash cost price. This is where the long-term value spawns from. This, in my opinion, is a home run. It's not easy, but it's incredibly rewarding when you get it at cost and see maybe 3 years down the road, the bottle price has jumped up in value and it's worth more. If you're collecting to drink, that might also mean the popularity of the whiskey has gone up because it's damn good. And it's now a lot more scarce than before because people are drinking it, which means there's not a lot left unopened. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Nowhere to buy from too. Distilleries have distillery exclusive bottlings that could be genuinely amazing. Auction sites, obviously, online retailers or brick and mortar stores. Even and most crucially possibly is whiskey societies. There are a ton of whiskey society bottlings to be grabbed up. Join a few. Great place for learning, drinking, trying, and meeting like-minded people with experience. But yeah, bottom line, get in at cost price. Number 9, boutique and small distilleries aren't always a shoe-in for a cash cow, or for their own distillery, distillate for that matter. For whatever reason, a boutique distillery may or may not be a great investment. It's incredibly hard to gauge if it's worth collecting or drinking. You need to pace yourselves here. And now there are a number of factors and reasons why this may or may not be, but again, research comes into play. Is it the distillery's own spirit released? If not, is it a reputable distillery that the supplied juice came from? What's the price point? What's the significance? How does distillery or company interact with customers, with social media? Are they fully transparent? Do they have a following? Are people chatting about them? Here comes this word again, research, and find out. Again, don't leave yourself in the dark here. Knowledge is power. If you're new to collecting, maybe start with some tried and trusted brands. That's just a thought. I think we're on number 9, that could have been number 8, but catalog everything. It doesn't matter what type of collector you are, buy some bottle tags, sticky tape your receipt to the bottle, write down some info on why you bought the bottle on the tag, keep a digital database if you want, a folder with a bunch of pictures and writings on the back of them, all the info you want to muster on that tag or database or whatever. Catalog. And trust me when I say, when you get into whiskey collecting, it won't be before long you've amassed a respectable size collection and you might forget how many bottles you have. More importantly, what you paid for them, the year you bought them, etc. This is something I kick myself for not doing time and time again. I really do beat myself up over this one. Catalog your bottles of whiskey and keep that catalog updated. And most importantly, Jesus Christ, keep it backed up. Finally, and I've saved this one for last because it's a biggie. Number 10, jazz hands. Repeat this part over and over and over and over again in your head. You are going to get burned at one stage or another. Yes, absolutely no way out of it. Come to terms with it now. If you're going to get into collecting whiskey, be prepared at one stage or another to pay too much money on a bottle or get a bottle with a shitty fill line or a torn label or it's the wrong year or God damn it, I got the wrong cast number. If you're collecting to maybe have a nest egg someday, then you know what? This really does suck and it hurts a little bit. If you're collecting just because you like the thrill of chasing and acquiring bottles, then this might not be so bothersome to you. Bottom line, you're gonna get stung someday on some bottle of whiskey somewhere along the line. Suck it up. It's all a part of the game. Just try not to let it happen too often and try to God to offload that bottle as quickly as you can if you don't want it in your collection. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you one bonus tip because as I was setting up here today to record some of this, I was talking to the lads here who have amassed a fantastic collection. Patience. I cannot tell you how many times that I have gone hell for leather to try and track down a specific bottling, a bottle from a cask selection that was released in a certain country. Single casks that are stupid money. For example, I wanted for the longest time a Redbreast 32 Dream Cask. I could not get one for years. I wasn't going to pay the kind of money that it was demanding at the time. I think it was around 2,000 euros. And I said, absolutely no way. One day, there was an online lottery and I joined it and I won. There you go. 2.5 to 3 years later, after the release, I won a bottle of it in an online lottery auction thingy. That might not happen to you, but my point here is be patient. Be patient. You don't know what's going to come along. You don't know, are price going to fluctuate? Are they going to go high? Are they going to go low? Are you going to get in at the right price point? Maybe you have a bottle of whiskey on the shelf that you collected that you're like, I don't really give a shit about that one, but it's worth a fortune. You could trade that, barter, it's a thing. Just be patient. Know that good things do actually come to those who wait, especially in the whiskey world. Yeah, I could be eating my words on that one, actually. There are a few whiskeys that have gone up substantially in price the longer I've waited, but I'm still waiting. There you go, there you have it. My top 10 tips for newbie whiskey collectors that are getting into the game in 2022. Congratulations, you've reached the end. Pat yourselves on the back. Yeah, pat yourselves, don't slap yourselves. Actually, before we go, just one more thing. Don't forget to like and subscribe and make sure you're following so you can stay up to date with each new video when it drops. Usually every Wednesday at 5:15 Irish time. Once again, I feel like it's my duty to reiterate that if you do get into collecting and realize after a while it's not for you, this happens, or you have a load of bottles that haven't really gone up in price point after some time, just relax. And always remember, you can always drink the whiskey. While I was coming up with the idea for this video, it kind of reminded me of another video I should perhaps think about doing, and it's kind of a follow-on that I'm going to do at some stage about storing your whiskey. That is a crucial point too. I think people should understand that. I didn't touch upon it in this one because this is kind of just a baseline to help you understand what's going to happen when you get into whiskey and what to look out for. So the next step then, of course, would be to acquire those bottles and indeed storing them. I am working on that at the minute. So again, make sure you're subscribed for when that video drops. And that's it, my friends. School is out. Run free. Chat to you next time. I'm the Whiskey Chaser Brian. Sláinte.